8 world ranking spots Bishop. Between these two teams, Johanna Golodczewski.
Bishop, you want green?
In the light
black.
Blue with her back to us.
Green.
And her partner, Carla Nelter.
Green.
Both ranked 18th in the world. They've been as high as 17th, just a place higher. That was back in June, a couple of months ago.
Carla
Nelter, well, she's also a very good mixed doubles player, as high as 25th in the world. Just going to undergo the warm-up. Court officials in place. And let the formalities begin. So, there we are, Johanna Golodczewski. They've played 16 tournaments together. They won two in the Brazilian Grand Prix 2014 and recently runner-up in the Russian Open, where they lost to the Stueva sisters from Bulgaria. They also made semi-finals in the Scottish Open and two quarter-finals as well. One of those being the Bitburger Open and also the US Open. Her partner today, Carla Nelter. So they've played 16 tournaments together, so very experienced. The winners of this match play against Ma Jin and Tang Yuanting, the sixth seeds in the women's doubles. And their opponents today, the Indonesians, 26th ranked, so just 8 spots between them. Kesha Nervita Hanedia and Devi Tika Permatasarai. There she is. That's all right. So they've played 11 tournaments together. Runners-up in the Indonesian Masters 2014, a long time ago now. Semi-finalists of the Thai International together, and they've made 3 quarter-finals as well this year. The Indonesian International, the Macau Open, and the Malaysian Masters. They've also had 6 first-round losses. There's just evidence that they've played once before. Previous meeting indeed going to the Indonesians in a very close 3-game battle, 21-16 third game. Should be a cracking match as we take a look at our umpire for the day, Andrea Ciappini from Italy. And his scorer, Gilles Cavert from France. Alongside me, Jesper Larsen. Welcome, Jesper. Good to work with you for the first time.
Thank you.
Should be an interesting match.
Definitely. I think we will be up for a very open match. As you also mentioned, the previous result showed that it's 2 even pairings. And I think we're going to see probably a very attacking Indonesian pairing and a more tactically playing German couple.
They have been in good voice, haven't they, the crowd so far. There's a fella dressed in a red and white box, obviously Indonesian, but he must be absolutely sweltering in this terrific stadium that is the Astora Stadium, the iconic venue built for the Asian Games 1962, home of world badminton, frankly, steeped in so much history. So many terrific matches have been played in this very venue. Seats up to about 10,000 people. It's not at full volume yet. There's still a lot more seats to be filled, but it's a terrific atmosphere nonetheless.
On my right,
Indonesia's going to get us underway then.
Johanna Golodczewski.
On the top of your picture. In this first round women's doubles encounter.
Kesha Nurvita Nadia. Devikita Permatasari. Devikita Permatasari to serve to Carla Nelter. Global play.
Or leave that one. Finding the line.
One.
Yes, but how much
love.
Psychological edge does that win for the Indonesians sort of matter, do you think, at this stage? Does it really help them? Or maybe when it comes to the crunch? What's your sort of take on that?
I think it will help them, but I also think that right now they're probably a little more anxious about the first match in the Senai, and it's World Championships on the home court, and I think they just need to get started.
Johanna.
Yeah, I guess it's all about the start, isn't it? Getting that scoreboard reeling.
Johanna. serves over 2-1.
For all four players, it's this is the first match they're playing in here, and it is a difficult place to play. There is a lot of draft, and they all got to get used to that. As you could see, the first rally, the Indonesians left the shot, and that one, if they played in here before, they would know that that one wouldn't go out.
I thought they might have had a little bit more sort of home exposure in this venue, but it seems not.
No, the venue is getting built up for the event, so it's not like they can go here and practice every day.
In her peripheral vision could see her opponent just closing that net down for the drop shot, and hence the just finding the tape on that occasion. So the Indonesians then with the marginal lead out here, still very early doors though in this first round women's doubles from Jakarta.
By the Germans.
Four.
Familiar Indonesian pairing of the seventh seeded duo of Pauli and Maheshwari in the women's doubles, quarterfinalists of last year. They won the Chinese Taipei and they came runners up here in the Indonesian Open, did those two.
Yeah, we are probably gonna see some good rallies here because none of these players has a big powerful smash and they're all very good defensively, so it will be difficult killing the shuttle, and it seems like we're gonna have some good rallies.
Serve is over, 6-4.
Who won that point?
Seven.
No prizes for that answer. Just a wall of noise every time Indonesians win a point. Fantastic atmosphere. I'd say it's only about a quarter full as well. Can't wait for the latter rounds.
Understanding by the Germans.
Yes, change.
This is our fourth match then on day two, Tuesday. We're bringing you a total of 14 matches today. Six men singles, three women singles, two women's doubles, and three mixed.
Serve is over. 5-8. Out. Service over. 9-5. 5.
Some expensive mistakes by the Germans. That's two service mistakes in a row, and also some receiving mistakes. You cannot afford that, especially not when you don't have this killing smash, so you can win rallies in that way. So you need they need to be a little more consistent.
Serve for court. Kisha. Too high. Racket.
Another service fault. Yeah. How about that?
Serve order. 6. 10.
Indicative, perhaps, of the early match tension, perhaps?
I think the service judge just wanted to remind him not to get that serve up too high. I don't think it looked very high,
10.
But... It's hard to see from up here.
It's got to be struck below the waist, of course. Smashing from the Germans, just keeping the pressure on.
They definitely are now, and every time they don't have a chance of hitting it, they just block it to the net and then they get a new lift. The Indonesians, they need to move forward if they want to have the attack.
Germans intent on reducing that marginal lead that the Indonesians have as they head towards the mid-game interval.
Out.
Another service ball, that'll frustrate them. So it's the Indonesians then, 2 points
and
ahead
goal.
As they head to the break.
Yeah, you can see the Germans actually, they made 3 service mistakes and 2 straight receiving mistakes. So out of the 11 points, that's quite a lot.
Coach, Germany.
So we're watching women's first round doubles, round of 64. The 18th ranked German duo, Golizewski and Carla Nelt, against 2 Indonesians, 26th ranked, Canadia and Kermatasarai, who indeed won their only previous match showing.
11-9.
The BCA Indonesian Open in 3 very close games. They have the marginal lead to the Indonesians by 2 points, 11-9.
Serve
you said, rightly
10.
So, Jesper, that the Germans
11.
Can ill afford those 3 service faults from the off. But it's interesting as well, I saw Johanna Golizewski just in the stadium down below, just sort of savouring the atmosphere before she came out and entered the arena. Very important to kind of get that feel, isn't it?
Yeah, it's important not to get scared of it, not getting scared of playing
11.
It against the Indonesians, but enjoying to play in a place where they appreciate badminton so much.
Yeah, it must be a real player privilege.
I think all of the players from the World Circuit have been looking forward to this
12,
event, and
11.
And as you said, the further we get into the week, the bigger the crowd is, and the more fun it's going to get.
Well, it's nip and tuck the whole way this opening game, but the Indonesians just keeping their noses in front out here in this race to 21 points, of course.
Yeah, until now, it's been in the service situations, the Indonesians have been best, and then when we get into the rallies, it seems like the Germans are very good to holding on to the attack and killing the shots. There you go once more.
13-0.
Good understanding that the Indonesians can't clear too high, right, with that drift, and so the Germans presumably can just close a little tighter. Yeah, as you said.
Yes, that's true. That's true. But as you can see, it is just hard to control the shuttle in here. Now the Germans, they are lifting it out, even though they have the threat against them. And once again, two mistakes in the service situation. And yeah, now they need to stick in there.
Well, we had a big upset on day one. Chu Tien Chen, the sixth seed in the men's singles, going out to Zulkifli of Malaysia. And we just had one in the women's singles as well. The loss of the 16th seed, local player, Indonesian, Kuzumastuti, out to Pei Yupo from Chinese Taipei. So it's all been happening. We're only on day two. Still five more days of play left.
When the Germans get into this situation where they are underneath the net, then they probably should just lift, because, as we spoke about, they have the drift against them, so Johanna, it should be possible to lift a shot from there.
Good early return.
Serves over. 16.
Yeah, they really need to get into the service situation and really be alert when the rally starts.
Oh, that's a poor leave. Just found the line. Nobody's challenged yet.
15, 16.
Thought we might have had one there.
Kisha.
When Nelsa hits it, it looks long, but when it's a high lift, then the draft will definitely stop it, and that's what the Indonesian didn't really get this time.
Called out there, spilling over the back line, the Indonesians there, and we level up here in this very competitive opening game. That's a better leave. The delight of the local fans.
Serves over. 17.
So passionate 16. And knowledgeable, the Indonesian crowd.
And you can also see the Indonesian couple now, they are trying to get the attack more. They're getting forward to the net. They're blocking more short shots, closing down the net. So now when they play rallies, they also have a chance now.
Yeah, both teams looking just that little bit more proactive, looking to go get the shuttle. Indonesia, again, snatching back the marginal lead here, just 2 points between them. Well, I like the idea of the aggressive early return, Johanna, but frustrated Johanna, by the tape.
Johanna! Johanna! Don't do more, okay? 19-16.
Just having a word there. Control your temper, please.
And again, when you lift from there, you need to really hit it high up in the air if you want to keep it in, because else the drift just carries it out.
Kisha.
So that's a big difference, is that if you lift it high, then the drift won't be as heavy as if you lift it flat. If you lift it flat, then you'll get a lot of drift on the shot. There are holding on to the attack now. The Germans are lifting a lot. They are not getting high at the net, and those block shots as they had before in the middle of the set, they kind of forgot that. So they need to take the attack back.
Three game points then. That's one save with a terrific return.
Serve is over.
Credit to Gorodetsky there. She closed the net down so fast. Got a good read on the situation.
And she was fast there. I think because of the service judge calling a fault earlier, they didn't expect the long serve, so she was fast to get that short one. There we go again, another lift into the drift.
Oh. And it's built wide again, and the Germans have leveled up here.
20.
Saving three game points.
That last one was a big chance there. Oh. Gonna be disappointed in that one.
Yeah, just came around the inside of the shuttle that a little bit too much. So back to level then. Oh, hesitancy there. Carla Nelke turning round mid-rally. Oh, that's frustrating for the Germans, having done all that sterling work to fight back to level.
21,
now it's the Indonesians with a
20.
Fourth game point. At least they can smile about it. I'm sure they're not feeling jubilant inside. Fantastic.
21.
Very watchable, this one.
Yeah, definitely. And that's another one that she has a great chance there of finishing off the set, and then she ends up making a mistake again.
Leave from Carla Nelke, who kind of redeemed herself for the sort of confusion
21.
On a point a couple of points ago. Very good leave. So that's given Germany a game point.
Germany!
Having saved four themselves, can they snatch this one? Germany. They're delighted with that effort, and they take the first game, 23 points to 21. A real epic opening game.
Coach.
Terrific badminton.
Long pen. Long pen. Long pen. Please.
Yeah, I just think the Indonesians, they really had some chances there finishing off the set, and they'll be disappointed in this. And on the other hand, I think the Germans really really got some self-confidence and got boosted by this. So this will be very difficult for the Indonesians to come back in. But let's see what happens now. It's easier to control the shuttle from the side where they're on now. So we'll see.
Opening game, then the Indonesians kept their nose in front throughout, but they squandered four game points in the end, and the German duo snatched it 23-21 in a very competitive opening women's doubles first round encounter here on court one from the Istora Stadium, Jakarta. Second day of the World Championships 2015. Opponent was there. There was a huge gap. Very, very good peripheral vision and court awareness.
The Indonesians have been talking about that when they are in the round ahead corner in the left side of their court, and they have Johanna standing cross court, and they go for her in the smash.
Serves because Johanna Golosevski so quick to pounce on that early return.
Yes, they might still be a little scared of the fault they received in the beginning of the match, so they keep on serving short. Close, isn't it? We have a challenge.
They're taking it upstairs. Hawkeye will decide. Very close. In this really crackling atmosphere now. In this four-quarter stadium. German coach there just snatching the opportunity to pass on some words of advice to Carla Nelta. As we await the decision from Hawkeye. Here it comes. Well, we hope. Seems to have frozen. Technology, eh? Such a blessing, though, Hawkeye, in all these racket sports. Tennis is the same. It really does engage the crowd. It's a fantastic decision to use it. I just wish we could get more challenges per match, frankly.
Yeah, I think you're right. And we also spoke about this yesterday, that it's... It's much better for the line judges also, because there are not so many arguments about the calls any longer.
Yes, and you don't get that sort of player-umpire intimidation factor, do you? And the arguments are minimized, which is all very respectful as well. We're still waiting for the Hawkeye decision. And Kolesarski's getting a little frustrated. Well, which screen do I look at?
We just got it here to the left.
Two, three.
It was in.
Carla.
So again, as in keeping with the opening game, the Indonesians with the marginal lead as they did throughout that first game.
If you notice now, the Germans, they are really moving forward all the time, and this is also why this happens. They want to try to keep the attack and not giving away the net to the Indonesians, so they really move forward. It's going to be exciting to see if that tactics will last.
Well, to remind those of you just joining us, we're watching women's first round doubles action.
Carla.
These two teams have met once before in the Indonesian Open.
Two.
And it was these two here in purple, the local players that came through in a very close three-set encounter. But they've lost the opening game here to the Germans. You're in the company of Jesper Larsen and Paul Hand. You stay with us for this one.
Two.
We've had the felling of a seed already in the women's singles. Out. Kumista Tutti. She's gone. Lindan, he came through the fifth seed earlier,
as
did
Sho
Sasaki of Japan. Lee Chong-wei is up later, as is Carolina Marin. Jano Jorgensen. They're all in action today. Do stay with us here.
Four.
14 matches we're bringing you in this badminton bonanza.
I think that's a good call. That one seemed very high, and service judge was ready.
Four.
Very hard to redeem the loss of that opening game, having had four game points themselves. Oh, she did so well to close, but just found the top of the tape in doing so.
Yeah, that was the right play. She was up there and she was trying to close it down, but just a little unlucky. Some good defense in this rally. Even smashes from mid-court and they were still picking it up.
Kesha. Five.
I think the Germans, they started off with a tactic putting a lot of push and pressure on the shots. And
Indonesia.
I don't really think that's the right way. I think they need to get up there and block the shots at the net and then get some good lifts so they can get the attack. This is, of course, also very good.
Six.
But if they keep on standing in the mid-court fighting the Indonesians, I think the Indonesians are the best ones at that.
Home to over 10 million people in Southeast Asia, Jakarta, a city of contrast, traditional and the modern. Its population comprises all ethnic groups of the Indonesian archipelago, living under the national motto, Unity in Diversity. Good work off the high backhand side from
nine.
Marginally taller of the two German players, Kolesetsky. Oh, beautiful drop from Nelter at the net.
Nine.
Yeah, I can also see now that they're communicating with the coaches out there in the back that this was the right way to play. They turned away, they turned the attack to their advantage, and this is what they need to do. They need to block the shots, get some lifts, and get the attack.
Serves over.
She had it again, right where she wanted it.
Nine.
Not been at her best, really close to the net. Nelter at the moment. Too errant. So, as in keeping with the first game, the Indonesians with the 2-point lead as they head to the mid-game interval. The Germans with the initial opening game swinging their way. Just getting some advice from the coaches then. And we'll resume in 1 minute.
Indonesia, thank you.
So a really intriguing first round women's doubles, this one. We knew it was going to be tight from the off because of their previous head-to-head encounter. That was a very close match in the Indonesian Open. Three close games, 21-16 in the third in the locals' favour. And this one turning out to be a real treat as well.
11-9.
Indonesians with the marginal lead in game two of 2 points, but they're trailing the game here.
And that serve was a little high, and Carla Nelson did very good killing it.
10, 11.
Hesitant there, Carla Nelter. Wasn't sure whether it was going to find the line or not as it dropped.
12.
Sort of all at sea with that one. Again, Indonesia with the 2-point lead. It's been a familiar feature, hasn't it, throughout this match? Yes, but they've had that 2-point buffer all throughout the first game.
Serves over. 11.
But of course, one of the things the Germans 12. Are doing a lot better now is they've eradicated those service faults. There was three of them. To go 9-11 in the opening game against them. A lot more consistent in that regard now. Really found their rhythm on serve.
Yeah, I think the Germans are hit. Once again, we have this cross court from the left side. Cross court going for Johanna. And she has a hard time getting those.
Yeah, Pumatasaray is really pounding over to that right-hand side, isn't she? Left to right, getting around her backhand smash well. The space was there, they left the gate open, the Germans, but just spilling wide. The Indonesian duo there.
Yeah, I think the Germans are still trying to handle the situation over there with the drift in the back, and they're not too unhappy about just being behind 1 point now, two again. I think the Indonesians they could use the court a little more now. They have the drift against them, but they allow the Germans to step forward all the time. I think they should try to put it over the head of them, lift it a little more, and then step forward afterwards. Both pairings knowing now that this is crucial, and some tension and mistakes building up here.
16-13. Hey, see? One feather is broken. One feather is broken. Change.
Points between them now in the Indonesians' favour. They're really getting a stranglehold over this game.
Yeah, they've been consistent now, the Indonesians, and the Germans has made some unprovoked mistakes.
Service over, 14-18.
Solid performance 14. In this game, doing what they couldn't do in the first game and just ride home that lead now. 2 points away from levelling up here and taking us to a deciding game.
The Germans, they kind of gave it away here. They were playing well and they were in this set, but some mistakes it's done, yeah, and yeah. Once more here, finishing off the set.
21-14 then, second they level up, and we're going to be treated to a third and deciding game. Analia, do stay with us after the break.
21-14, one game all.
So little between these two teams. Been out there almost 40 minutes. We've split games in this really terrific stadium for World Badminton. No prize money on offer, of course, in this event. But the winners of the event come Sunday, standing on the gold medal podium, will be crowned as the world champions. That has a nice ring about it.
Got 120 seconds. Got 120 seconds.
So, one game apiece out here. Nelta just trying to gee herself up and keep energized in this all-important deciding
final
game. It's the Indonesians to get us underway.
Play.
To be fair, they did what they couldn't do in the opening game, and that was consolidate their lead. They had four game points in the open game, but squandered it, handed the initiative over to the Germans, who snatched the game. But they flushed that away mentally, didn't carry it at all, and credit to them mentally, and they've leveled up here wonderfully. So just at the start of the third game.
Joanna. Joanna, too high.
One.
Johanna once more got called here for a high serve. I think we're going to see a lot of pressure on the short serve now, and Johanna's trying to do the same here because none of them are allowed by the service judge to serve long. And this means that they can really go hard at the short serve.
In the name of being aggressive, you've got to compliment her tactic, but she's just clipping the tape on numerous occasions, Carla Nelta.
Yes, I think instead of putting these shots back towards the person in the back on the Indonesian side, they should just, the Germans, they should block the shots instead. It won't be as risky, and they will get a good attacking possibility afterwards.
Serves over, two, three.
It's easy from up here, isn't it?
Definitely.
Again, the Indonesians just that little bit more solid, not giving his way, well, very, very few errors, frankly.
Yeah, you're right. It seems like Carla Nelta feels a little insecure and is making a few mistakes here.
Oh, it's landed in.
Five.
Wonderful reflexive
two.
Backhand from the Indonesian duo. So, 3-point advantage now. Can they consolidate? Build on all the good work from the middle game.
Too high.
Struck above the waist again.
Three.
It's becoming a familiar feature of this match. Good to see, though, from the umpire and the scorer.
Yeah, I don't know if I really agree. I think he's maybe a little too tense and a little too big a part of the game. I don't think the servages are so high that he needs to call them every time they serve long.
Serve. 6-3.
Oh, that's unlucky.
Yeah, we were both sitting up here waiting to see what the umpire was calling.
So hard to see that one unless you're looking from the side, as one of our cameras is.
I think the Indonesians, they look quite comfortable now. They a good defense, and they believe that when they get the attack, they can get through the Germans' defense. I think the Germans really need to stay in the game now if they need to, or if they are going to have a chance to win this match.
Strong overhead. Kamakatsurai there, really bullying that smash away. So a buffer of 5 points now then, the serving duo here in purple. Four players, experienced campaigners. Just 8 world ranking spots between them, these teams. 18th ranked the Germans, 26th ranked the Indonesians.
But I do think now that the Indonesians, the way they've been playing now is probably the level they normally have. But I think being on home ground and playing here in Indonesia maybe has put a little more tension on them, and they, in the beginning, they had a harder time playing.
And also they're playing off their career high as well, so they really are on a good run of wins. To remind those of you just joining us, they were runners-up in the Indonesian Masters. That was actually of last year. Did okay as well in the Indonesian Open. Well, they beat these two anyhow. So, still a lot of work to do then for the two Germans. They're fighting tooth and nail at every single point, straining every sinew in order to clear the net one more time. Drift just drags it to the right.
Serves over.
As we've seen so often from our commentary position here on court one.
Yeah, I know we talk a lot about this drift, but it is just so important playing in here that if you don't notice the drift, and if you don't if you're not planning your tactics with the drift, then you don't stand a chance in here.
Am I right in understanding that you could go gently from left to right then, but when you want to really hit your power smashes, you want to sort of aim over to the left a little more, presumably?
Yeah, that's true. I think that's especially when you go cross court. That if you go cross court from the side here that the camera is on, if you go cross court from the right to your left, then you can hit it harder. If you go cross court the other way, you really need to be careful.
So, to the break we go. The Indonesians 5 points ahead, 11-6 in this deciding game, women's opening round doubles here. To remind you, opportunity for the winning team to pit their skills against the 6th seeds, Ma Yin and Tang Yunting from China. China, the country that's had just a big stranglehold over this event. The last 12 gold medals going to the Chinese in the women's doubles.
That's quite impressive,
seconds.
Isn't it?
Indonesia, coach. Germany, coach. Yeah, I know. Please, on court. Carla, on court. Carla, you are receiving. You are receiving.
Well, in this crackling atmosphere out here, quite hard to hear the umpire. He's really having to bellow out his instructions. It's the Germans with it all to do. The Indonesians look like just that little bit smoother, a bit more in touch with the conditions out here. 5-point lead they have, 11 points to 6 as we resume in this final game.
12. Now, once again, Johanna's going for the sideline, and the drift is just carrying it out. If you're going this way, you're going to go for the inner line instead of the outer line.
No, Nice finish from Nelta there, really closing it down and getting some snap on that smash.
7-12.
Maybe the Indonesians are being a little too relaxed about it now. The Germans are really trying to boost themselves and get into this game. And the Indonesians, if they want to keep this score, they got to speed up again.
I guess psychologically as well, when you've gone to the sort of mid-game interval and you're leading by five or so points, it is hard to keep that momentum and keep pushing when you resume, yeah. That's a poor lead from Golicevski, who thrashes the shuttle away, irritated.
Now that one was quite far in.
6 points between them now, then.
Sevdova, 9-14.
The service judge might as well just tell them that you cannot serve long, so why try?
Out!
Well, the problem that
serves over, 15,
fell over them in the first game is with them again in this final game. The Germans made too many service faults in that opening game. Well, she was obscured. She couldn't go lights out of that smash because Carla Nelta's head was right
15.
There. But anyway, she got it away.
It looked like she was not really sure about which one of the Germans was going to hit that one.
So presumably in that situation, Jesper, it's all about screaming as loud as you can. It's mine, right?
Yes, that's true, but I think Carla Nelta actually went for the shot. She just missed it, so Johanna was just the backup.
Yeah. Still, the Indonesians in control in this deciding game for a berth in round two. Of course, the World Championship's laden with world ranking points.
7-10.
And of course, people are vying for to do as well as they can here because the Olympic qualifying year up for grabs, big points, means a lot to them to get a win here. Every single match is just loaded.
Service over.
Exactly what these players
11,
are after. There's no prize money
16.
On offer. It's all about the points. And in these big level one events, the Olympics as well, you can boost your ranking right up through the roof. Good put away from Nelta. She's missed a few of those today. That was
12,
a timely one.
17.
Still time to claw this back.
But just hitting the tape.
Kisha.
That's a good serve. Just putting a little, she's changing the angle a little bit. Normally she goes towards the middle, but this time she just changed it a little bit, serving more to the left, and Johanna was quite surprised by that.
A little bit of miscommunication amongst the Indonesian team there, just exposing
19.
The gap the Germans did and hitting down through the gap in the court nicely. Oh, terrific power smash from Golosevsky there.
14, 19.
It was like Nadia just got surprised that I was actually able to serve a long serve without getting called by the service judge.
Nice skills on the high backhand drop. Again from Golosevsky.
Kisha, shuttle.
Who has a mixed doubles ranking of 259. They're the higher-ranked team, marginally, the Germans. You wouldn't think so. It's a wonderful crash down the line.
19.
And this time using the drift from left to right, so she hits it towards the sideline, but it comes in on the left side.
Indonesians just 2 points from the second round
17,
here, but they're going to have to be a little
19.
Bit proactive. They've been, depending on unforced errors
Indonesia.
From the German team, but they're going to have to go after it, you feel, at this stage.
You're definitely right. They're kind of hoping that the Germans will help them to the victory, and Germans seem ready now, but this time the Indonesians went for the point. And the crowd likes it.
20.
They certainly do. What a hullabaloo they're causing right now. Delighted
17.
That their team have three match points. It's landed out. It's called out. The Indonesians through then. Oh, there's been a challenge, has there?
Yeah, there might as well, but I don't think there's any chance that this one was in. So.
Smacks of desperation, this one, doesn't it? But even the Germans are laughing. But of course, they can't shake hands. It's not concluded yet. The heartbeat is pumping.
And as you mentioned earlier, this is what the challenge system does. The crowd loves it.
Oh, they found the back of the line. How about that? They're still alive.
Challenge successful.
That is very surprising. I saw that one as being far away from the line.
And this is where Hawkeye is 20. Fabulous in my eyes, where the smallest of margins can have the largest of consequences. If they go around and turn this around, well, hats off to Hawkeye.
That's mentally tough for the Indonesians, thinking that they have won and then still have... Carla Nelson broke a string. This is why the smash ended up in the net.
They're delighted. It's hugs and smiles all round for the Indonesian duo. They're through against the Germans. So it's Kesia, Nervita, Hanaria and Devitika. Permatasarai. Safely through after just inside an hour. 21-18 in the final game. What a match that was.
Anadia, Devikita,
and what a way to lose it. Breaking the string and in that way not being able to get the shuttle over.
Confirmation of our score then, just inside 59 minutes. The Indonesians through, the 26th ranked duo, 21-23, they lost the first game, then they won the next two, 21-14, 21-18. Confirmation there that they're safely through to round two where the sixth seeds await. Mai Yin and Tang Wenting. Do stay with us because we'll be bringing you our next matchup, which is a mixed doubles between another Indonesian duo, Tontowi Ahmed and Liliana Natsir. They're up against the Russian duo. But for now, delight from the fans. The Indonesians through safely to round two. The Germans, well, they played their part. Cracking atmosphere out here. leave you with some highlights of this one. Then that we'll be watching Fontoi Ahmad and Liliana Natsir up next here on court one against the Russians Kaliev and Bolotova from Russia in the mixed doubles. Second round action from the top of the second quarter of the draw, just awaiting our players. That's the section they're in. Third seeds on display next. It's going to be a real treat to watch them play. Just awaiting our players. I'll tell you more in a minute.